and Assalamu alaikum. My name is Nur Farhanis binti Kamaluddin, and for this final video assignment, I will be reviewing Distinguished Lecture Number 4, where Prof. Jim Mark-Linares was invited to share the stage and talk about additive manufacturing technology, quick delivery of products for COVID-19 virus protection. As we all know, COVID-19 is caused by the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which spreads between people, mainly when infected person is in close with another person. The virus can spread from an infected person's mouth or nose in small liquid particles or droplets produced when they cough, sneeze, or speak. These droplets are too heavy to stay in the air and fall quickly. Other people can catch COVID-19 when the virus gets into their mouth, nose, or eyes, which is more likely to happen when people are in direct or close contact less than 1 meter apart with an infected person. To prevent the coronavirus from keep spreading, an initiative has been taken in medical field where its aim is in brief to assist frontliners in handling this critical situation regarding the COVID-19, which is to use additive manufacturing in creating products for COVID-19 protection. Additive manufacturing has been a good technological support for fight against the COVID-19 as it has allowed to answer very quickly to hospital first needs after the industry has taken relay since the pandemic. Since then, people have been taking this opportunity to use additive manufacturing with the only aim, which is to help healthcare workers who are in despair due to the lack of hospital equipment and safety guards for them to use to combat with these invisible enemies. And thanks to this technology, lots of products have been created with the sole purpose of protection from COVID-19. Here is some of the examples. First is the application of Decathlon swimming mask. Due to the lack of medical equipment, doctors and researchers have come to an idea by using the swimming mask and transform it to the respiratory mask for COVID-19 patients with respiratory difficulties. This idea came after medical shortage in Italy due to the number of COVID-19 patients kept increasing day by day, forcing doctors to improvise respiratory assistance solution. Another product is protective visor. As the healthcare workers act as the frontliner, they have markedly higher risk of becoming infected with the coronavirus, especially if they are exposed to a high volume of sick patients in the emergency room or respiratory secretion. And this is where protective visor come in handy, as they are simple, transparent skin that cover the face and help prevent infectious droplets from entering the eyes, nose, and mouth. Next is door opener. Before this pandemic happened, this tool might be something unusual for us, as they might not be useful to use in our daily life. But since right now, we are trying to minimize the contact between our skin and surfaces that we touch every day, such as door handle, light switch, and also the button of ATM machine, this tool become very convenient for us to avoid further passing of coronavirus. Last but not least is minimal universal respirator. Citizen of group consists of doctor, researcher, and scientists have been working on the creation of an emergency artificial respiration device that is cheap and easily reproducible. And that's where the idea of creating MUR come. However, the design is still an early stage and the developers are calling for contributors to add the missing skills. So in conclusion, the popularity of additive manufacturing has increased, especially in the medical field. Thanks to the declining prices of machines, 3D printers, and materials such as polymer, as well as free software to download, as more people using this manufacturing in helping the healthcare workers during this global pandemic. That's all from me. Thank you for watching.